I'm on.
Oh?
I'm on. Looking smooth now. Okay, good. Sorry about that. I've restarted the computer. Twitch is live. So I think that might be a little bit better. Let me know if it's jumping at all. Seems like it's all good so far. YouTube is live. Good. Welcome back. Thanks for sticking with me, guys. YouTube is live. Okay. So I'm going to get up and actually just start dancing a little bit more. Good, Facebook's live again. I'm going to just dance a little bit so that you can see if it's jumping or not. Okay, I think that has fixed it though, so thank you for bearing with me. Okay, let's see. Woohoo, we're back. Good, okay. Doesn't seem like I'm jumping, so I think that's fixed the problem. Let's go back into the question and answer bit. Okay, so we've gone straight into the drum. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, to the down. Okay, remember that's a toe at the back. So I'm doing it on my right foot. If you're more comfortable with your left foot in front, that's fine as well. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm trying to say it at the same time for you. 1, 2, 3, 4, and toe. 1, 2, 3, 4, toe. Okay? Good, all good now. Perfect, everyone. Okay. Hi again, how are you doing today? I'm good, Jennifer. We had a few little bit of technical difficulties, but I think we're back now. Okay, so welcome everybody. Welcome back. Let's get this piece done because then it means that we've pretty much done the whole breakout, doesn't it? So back again from this start of it. 1, 2, 3, 4, and toe. Then we're gonna go click toe, and then we're gonna go hop front. So your right foot's in front, and then you're gonna go and treble and point, look. So just watch that last bit, and treble, point, look. Okay, so if you notice on this point, I've got a bent knee, I'm keeping my shoulders back, and I've kind of got like my hands in a little heart or diamond shape, just on my hip here. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, so keep toe, and down, and treble, point, look. And we're gonna look at the girls on the opposite side of the stage, then our hands are going to come straight down, and we're going to go and dip and turn, look. Okay, so hop 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, turn, look, and then we're going to continue on again and kick your bum and turn to the front. Okay, so it's actually probably easier than you think it is, okay, or than it looks with the second part of it anyway. You've just got to get this drum and get the timing right. So you're gonna go straight into it, 5, 6, ready, and look, look, okay, and then we're gonna go straight into our sassy bit. So I think that's covered it for you. Let's do it a few times though. And Sarah, I know that you're dancing this along as well, so I'll face away, okay? So left foot in front, our hands are behind us. 5, 6, ready, and, okay? And remember, we're gonna turn to our body at an angle like that. So when we do the drum, we're gonna turn this way, keeping our head still out to the front, and then the first tip and toe is gonna stay to the front. So we stay to the front, on this, then we kick to the side, kick side, and treble and point, look to the side again. Ready? 5, 6, ready, and look. Okay, and again, 5, 6, ready, and look. Okay, from here, kick your bum. So that's our whole question and answer bit. Doing it with your socks on, that's okay, that's great. Okay. Such great makeup. Do you like wearing makeup? Were you taking classes for it? No, I've never taken a class for it. You just get to know what you're doing from doing it so much in the show. And you really get a hang of it. I don't know about you, but just watch your hands when you're doing that question and answer bit. I hit my hands all the time. I've got really long arms. So when I'm doing those kicked toes, I keep smacking them really hard, which is a good sign because it means that you're kicking up at the back, which is exactly what we want in this part. Okay, let's challenge ourselves now and let's do the question and answer bit straight into the sassy part. Okay, so we can combine those two things that we've done today. So ready? 5, 6, ready, and... And into the sassy bit. 1 and 2, and 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, turn to the back. Okay, good, and I don't think it jumped at all, so it's great. Getting there slowly, the first half is a bit tricky, the second half not too bad, I'll watch back and slow things down. That's okay, Sarah, let's do it really slowly again, and I'll break it down a little bit more, because I'm sure there's other people as well that would like it a little bit more slowed down, okay? So we'll do that again before we change into our lights, because I want to do a few of our drills to slip jig timing today before we move on to the reels, okay? So one more time with that bit, nice and slow. So the first drum, remember we go down, toe, heel, toe, down, toe, heel, down, tip, and toe. Okay, I'm gonna slow it down a little bit more and I'll turn away from you. Down, toe, heel, down, tip, down, toe. So, and again, down, toe, heel, down, tip, and toe. 2, 3, and from here you're gonna just click toe, so click toe, and click again, click toe. Now you're gonna go click down, so click down, and travel, and point, look. Okay, 5, 6, ready, and look. Okay, I think that will have been slowed down a little bit for you. So let me know if that's okay. Do you like sports? Yes, I love sports. I always loved playing them when I was growing up as well. I did kind of nearly everything, to be honest. All trying to dance at the same time, but I did a little bit of basketball. I did softball. I did tennis. I did some soccer. I did swimming. I did horseback riding. Hi Mary, it's Harriet. Hello Harriet. Hope you are okay. Harriet's a little girl I teach at Keegan Academy, and she is a fab dancer. She's come on so much. She's not been dancing too long, but she's a very quick learner. So we might see her in the show one of these days. How often do you soak your feet in ice? I've actually not soaked them in ice for quite a while now. I wouldn't really soak them unless if I was on tour, but my feet have been so sore lately. I think it's time to start doing it again. I want to see the show again and meet the full cast. Well, Sean, you will have to definitely come out and see us the next time, wherever we are. Helping lots, yes, thanks. Could you go through it just a few more times, ideally facing away? That helps me a lot. Yes, of course. Okay. Let's go through it again. So remember, left foot's in front, because you're actually going to kick up into the drum. So you're going to go up, 2, 3, 4. Okay? So, and we're going to turn to the side. Up, 2, 3, 4, tip, bend, toe, kick, toe, kick, toe, and down, and travel, and point, look. Okay? From here, pop, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and turn, turn, okay? Just close this down. Okay, one more time. five, six, ready, and... Look. Okay, so those are just tips, and your right foot's always going to come forward on them when we go. Okay, and you're going to finish with that left foot in front. Okay, one last time, and I'm going to keep doing it slowly for you, Sarah, so just let me know if this makes it a little bit more sense. Five, six, ready, and... Okay, and then straight into our sassy bit. Let's do that. Five, six, ready, and... One, and two, and one, two, three. One, and two, and one, two, three. One, and two, and one, two, three. Turn to the back. One, and two, and one, two, three. One, and two, and one, two, three. Okay, there we go. Yeah, that's a good pace for me. Had a bit of trouble of some of it, but I'll probably get it with more practice. Yes, definitely. Remember, we've been doing this for so long that it might seem like it looks really easy, okay? But if you just keep going at it and you keep practicing it and you just do it at a slower pace and then you can build up the speed, it will get a lot easier for you, okay? The most important thing is that you're trying your best and that you're doing little bits and pieces. That's better than not doing anything at all, so well done. Gives two thumbs up emojis. Thank you. Getting closer, I'll practice some more. Good. You mentioned you like English. Do you like history as well? I do like history. I wasn't as great with it when I was in school like I was with English, but no, I did enjoy history. And I certainly am more interested in it now. The older I get, I like it a little bit more. Amazing. Good stuff. Okay, so remember, that's breakout. That's in the first dance, or in the first half. Okay, if you've ever seen the show. When we're all in traditional dresses, everyone's got a different colored dress. And it's got the Velcro on the inside of it. Okay, or little snaps. When it comes off... So we've actually learned all those main pieces in breakout. So well done if you've stuck with it and you've stayed with me. So happy to be learning these steps. I learned the rest of breakout quite a while ago, and this will allow me to complete the dance. Good. I know, because you were saying that this was the one section that you didn't really have. So I hope you can piece together the full dance now. I hope to learn as much as I can. I've always wanted to learn Irish dancing. Well, you've come to the best place, because we are teaching you some of everything from the basics of Irish dancing all the way up to professional dancing showpieces. So you've definitely come to the right place. Virtual hugs from Vader, Washington. I love watching these episodes. You are all so impressive. Thank you, Vicky. And thank you for watching. Okay. I'm going to take off my heavies and let's put my lights on, or your lights on if you've got them as well, and let's get started with some of those drills. Okay? I agree, the boys should do a female dance. Yes, definitely. I'd be completely exhausted if I could do the whole dance in one go, though. You were all in the show are incredible. Yes, it does feel like quite a long dance, because if you have seen Breakout, the first section of it is the slowed down bit, so that seems like a dance in itself, doesn't it? And then you go on and you do the full fast motion dancing and into the sassy bit, so it's quite a long dance really, but it's great fun. How much sand did Winston track into the car? Oh, don't even get me started, Jason. Not good. Finding sand everywhere, and especially when I'm very OCD, I like a clean house, I like a clean car, I like clean floors. So it's not been great having the puppy drag in a ton of sand. I think I've hoovered nearly every day this week. It's become an obsession. But the main thing is that he had such a good day, and I think we might go again sometime this week, just because we've got to make the most of the good weather. Watched Lord of the Dance many years ago, been hooked ever since, never tired, love it. No, you can never get tired of it. How do you chat to family when on tour? I think FaceTime is great. I use it. I'm actually away from my family most of the year. My family all lives in the US, so I'm very familiar to chatting on FaceTime. Have you ever fallen on stage? I've fallen maybe twice. I think last week we were chatting about my first lead show and I fell up the stairs. So I finished the full routine of Gypsy and I was running up the stairs at the very end of the routine and I was trying to skip a step. Instead of doing each step, I was trying to skip one in between and I just didn't plan it. I did plan it. I just don't know if the nerves got to me or if I just wasn't up far enough on the stage when the music was at a certain point, and next thing I just completely slammed down on my face, slammed my shin into the stair, still managed to finish in time somehow. But that was the one time that really stands out to me. The other time I wouldn't really say it's a massive fall, but it was during my first tour when I used to dance Cry of the Celts. I'm not really in that number anymore because I'm in Awakening, which is another dance that we had done a few weeks ago. But I was dancing in Cry of the Celts and our old shoes that had a good like 2 or 3 inch heel that we were chatting about clipped onto the back of my dress and I couldn't get it out. So naturally you can imagine, I'll just kind of demonstrate for you. You always are kicking up at the back like this. So when I'm kicked, the heel of my shoe got caught in the bottom of the dress. And then next thing, I was just going straight down like that. But it was quite funny. It's a memory I won't forget. Okay, let me get my lights on just while I'm answering a few more questions. Do we feel like we're getting a little bit more confident with Breakout? Or are we enjoying the steps? Let me know if you enjoy doing them or if there's something else you'd prefer. Okay, but you've done well now because we've added a little bit each week. Okay, so we've built up to the full dance now. Okay. Remember, stay hydrated. Have a drink of water if it's next to you. Never look at Breakout again without seeing that section as the sassy bits. I know I'm gonna start calling it that all the time. You enjoy it so much. Good. It's a little bit different, isn't it? It's fun to be able to move your feet like that and to get those really nice beats, but to also add a little bit of sass, isn't it? Put in the shoulder rolls, add in the hips. Something different than we normally do. Okay, and remember, everybody can always be practicing it. Even if you're sitting down, you can still join in and give the shoulders. I used to learn tap dancing for a few years, over 10 years ago, so I guess I could still pick up some Irish dancing. Of course you can. I know tap dancing isn't the same, but you've definitely got an advantage with knowing how to keep time and different rhythm patterns. Oh, that's a funny question. Have you ever giggled or broken character somewhere when you shouldn't have? I somehow have this thing whenever I'm doing lead with Katrina, who also plays Saoirse, and we do two girls together. We're both our friends in real life, and on the stage, we're obviously pulling the most mean faces ever at each other. And sometimes you just kind of do a little bit of a smirk, and it just gets the other one laughing. So every time, it's more of, you need to focus more on not making each other laugh, really. But no, that's the only time, really. What's your favorite holiday? Oh, I love every holiday, but you're making me jealous about thinking about going on one now. I love going to Italy. I love Tuscany. Like that Tuscan sun and the heat, and what you can't go wrong with a little bit of cheese and wine tasting and different olive oils. Saying that, I do love the beach as well. I love going to San Diego. I love going to any beach. You don't have to ask me twice. If you don't have lights just yet, what other shoes do you recommend? You can do it in socks, yes. Might be a little bit safer to do it in trainers. Just when we do rocks and different moves like that, you want a nice sturdy foot. You don't want to be rolling any ankles. Oh, sorry. My favorite holidays are Christmas and Thanksgiving. Okay, that is where I'm getting all my words twisted. I forget that if I was speaking to an American, a holiday would be considered like Christmas or Thanksgiving. My favorite, yes, that kind of holiday. I would say it would be Thanksgiving. I love Thanksgiving because what's there not to like? Just loads of food. And especially in Phoenix, where I grew up, Thanksgiving is always in November, obviously, and that is the best weather in my opinion. It's a really nice time to be in Phoenix and to be celebrating. Best beaches you've ever been to? I loved Ipanema Beach in Rio. Okay, so that was in Brazil on tour last year. It was such a nice beach, and I loved drinking out of the coconuts every day. That would be one of my favorite beaches, I think. Trying to think of where else. I suppose, depending where you are, all the beaches just kind of have a different feel. You know, you definitely feel more tropical drinking out of a coconut when you're in Brazil compared to obviously when you're going to the beach here. Will you show another Irish step? Yes, I've got my lights on now. And we're going to do quite a lot of Irish steps now, and we're going to do them to music. This video and your other videos will be on YouTube and Twitch so that I can always practice. Yes, you can always look back anything that we've done, and you can replay it a million times if you'd like and slow it down. Do you show the kids in your family some steps just for fun, of course? I actually only have older siblings, really, and older cousins. So, actually, saying that, no, I've got a few younger cousins, but they're not really at the age when they would be learning some Irish dance steps. But that's actually a good point. Maybe I need to start teaching them a few moves. What's your favorite chocolate? I don't really like chocolate, to be honest. I know that sounds crazy to some of you, but if I did eat chocolate occasionally, I would like a milk chocolate, maybe with like salted caramel in it. Or sorry, not salted caramel, sea salt. Don't know why I did that, thinking of salt. Are the school years and bank holidays different in the US? Yes, I think that the school years are 1 year off to the UK. So I can't ever remember if it's say if you're in year six in the US, I can't remember if that's year five here or year seven. I can't remember if it's one in advance or one below, but I know they're not the same, and they're actually called different things. And in the US, we would call it elementary school or middle school and high school. And I know that they call it high school here as well, but we've got primary school and secondary school. I'm still getting my head around it as well. It can be a very confusing knowing all the different names and different terms in two different countries, and we don't have bank holidays in the US, so that's something different. Favorite ice cream then? I'd have to go with mint chocolate chip or pistachio, but then again, you could probably give me any kind of ice cream and I would eat it. Again, not a massive fan of chocolate ice cream though. You guys are always making me hungry though. We're always chatting about different foods. And now you're making me crave the beach. Okay, lights are on. I think we should jump straight into the music this time, okay? And then afterwards, you can teach or you can tell me which parts you want to do without the music and we'll break them down, okay? Do you teach all age groups at the Keegan Academy? Yes, all age groups. At the minute, we're not doing adults just because there's been so much going on and not enough time. but we will be in the future. But anything from ages 3 to 18, all of those ages. Can you hear that? That's the ice cream man. What a coincidence. We're chatting about mint chocolate chip and pistachio. Maybe I need to stop him. Hello from Mexico. Hello, welcome. Okay, getting on the Fesh app now. And we're gonna start off with the slip jig first. Ice cream, I know, could you hear that? How funny. Must have been 10 seconds after you were chatting about ice cream. Send James out. Need to train Winston to fetch the ice cream van, don't I? If he can dance, then he can go and sit at the end of the road and stop for it. Do you like Yorkshire puddings? Yes, I love them. Had a Sunday roast yesterday and had a big fluffy Yorkshire pudding, but I didn't eat it in time and it was cold. But yes, I do like them. Okay, slip jig is coming on and we're going to go into our pirouettes. One minute, bear with me. What are the odds of the ice cream truck going by? I know. Okay, so let's start with the right leg. Of luck today, are we? Lucy Walker says, I'm so excited for the challenge this week, Mary. Oh, I'm so excited to see it as well. We've set a little challenge. We keep setting challenges for the children each week to stay motivated and to do different things at home, to keep busy and to still stay in the mood, the Irish dancing mood. And this week's challenge is for the children to put on their wig on a parent. So it's a little bit different. Instead of always being the child and always having the wig on, they finally get to do it on mom or dad. So that will be very interesting, seeing all of them attempt and great practice as well, because I'm sure a lot of dancers are missing getting ready for feshes now. There's not been a fesh in quite some time, so you can imagine how much people miss it when every single Saturday or Sunday is spent getting all dolled up and preparing for a fesh. Little jumpy again, not as bad as before. I know I did see that a little bit. That's good that it's not as bad as before though, okay? Let's go into our jump shivers, and we're gonna go straight into cross keys after that, okay? And I hope that the music stays okay. Any particular fesh you remember getting really pumped up for? Gosh, did so many different feshes throughout the course of my life. The feshes, the different types of feshes in the States, some of them are so much fun. So where I grew up in Phoenix, we had a great fesh, and it was always a really fun event because there were pools everywhere, obviously, in the hotel. The fesh was held in a hotel, different ballrooms, you know, different stages were in different rooms, and the entire hotel had different hot tubs and different pools, and so much fun preparing and getting all of your dances done and doing really well and then jumping in with all your friends. So I always got pumped up for those Phoenix Feshes. Think we need to find a venue here that's got a nice indoor swimming pool. I recommend you try Cornish food. Yes, I've not ever tried that. A bit jumpy for me, but you can still keep up all right. Okay, great. Okay, I'm going to change the slip jig this time. We had a favorite last week that wasn't Stolen Kiss, but it was more of that traditional music. Okay, so I'm going to put that one back on again so that we can do it our shivers and our cross keys to that. Technical note, either the broadcast computer is low on RAM or the ingest server is overloaded. Either way, let's give it up for Mary to keep the show going. Yes, yeah, sorry about that, guys, if it is jumping. I hope that you can still follow along and it doesn't distract you too much, but we will definitely fix it so that it doesn't happen again going forward. Okay, slip jig. Okay, so into our jump pirouettes. Remember, we change feet in this. So we start with the right leg and we change onto the left and then vice versa, okay? Sorry guys that it is freezing a little bit there, but you are all pros and you've been staying with me for the last few weeks, okay? So even if it does jump a little bit, we always can remember or refer to those other weeks when we spent quite a bit of time doing the different pirouettes and shivers and cross keys, okay? So you guys are the pros now. Remember to keep practicing them. On that note, I'm going to slow things down a little bit just so that I don't lose you completely. And we can take a minute to do our splits challenge, okay? Just to keep it and let Twitch catch up with me. Okay? Chat only for the last 20 minutes without music. Okay. Great. Yes, we'll keep the music off and we can continue chatting and doing a little bit of our splits to do a little bit of our cool down, okay? So thank you for bearing with me. Remember, we chatted about the four different exercises to get our splits perfect, okay? Have you been doing them at home, or have you been getting a little bit further each week? I hope you have, and I hope you feel a little bit more flexible, okay? If you haven't, I'm gonna show you now. I'll do it nice and slow so I don't jump on you. But we're gonna go over those four moves, okay? So that first one is a lunge where we're just stretching out that back calf muscle and leaning forward. Okay, then remember we lock both legs. So this is for our hamstrings now, and we're gonna go all the way down, both hands on both sides of your feet. I'll move back a little bit so you can see me. Okay, even if you're here, hold the stretch. Then we lean back. Okay, so this front foot is nice and far out in front of you. And we're just not dropping the knee just yet, but we're kind of letting it dip a little bit lower. And you should feel this all in your hip flexor here on the side. Okay, drop the knee, push forward again. Okay, lean back. Stretch out that hamstring again. This is a great exercise even for me because, believe it or not, sometimes the splits hurts myself. Not hurts, but sometimes it's tough for me, especially if I'm quite sore. Okay, so then we're gonna go straight down into them and hold it. Remember, even if that leg is up, hold it there. Hold your personal best, okay? And you're gonna hold that for 2 minutes, okay? Remember, I've just gone through that nice and quickly, but you'll hold each stretch for 2 to 3 minutes. Thanks for keeping everything up. I'm still really enjoying myself this evening. Good, at least, yeah, it didn't affect you learning all the sassy bits and breakouts. That's great. I tried the split stretches at home. I am a long way off yet, though. How much should we be pushing in with these stretches? So with the splits, it shouldn't be comfortable. I'll say that. But it shouldn't be painful. It should feel slightly uncomfortable. You should be pushing yourself, but most importantly, holding that stretch. If it just gets to be a little bit uncomfortable and you kind of hold it for a second or 10 seconds and then relax, you're not going to get more flexible. So try to go down into that position that you start to feel a little bit uncomfortable and hold it for a full 2 minutes. And remember, right now is the perfect time to do it, okay? So our muscles are always nice and warm, obviously, after we've danced. Anytime that you're just doing a little bit of a practice, even if you're at home and you've done a run or a walk, come in and then do your split stretches, because that's when you're going to really push and stretch out those muscles. It's great after a hot shower as well, or a bath. Thanks, I'm having a lot of fun. Good, everyone. Okay, let's get up and do that left leg now. And let's see if you're getting any more flexible, okay? Remember, my left leg is even my weak leg. So you will have one leg that you feel is a lot easier to do. That's normal. You don't need to think that you're just not talented or really inflexible on that side. One leg will be better. Unless you're just very lucky and both legs are perfect. But let's get up now and do that left leg split stance, okay? So remember, this one isn't really, the calf stretch isn't to help you with the splits. It's just another great one to do for your Achilles tendon. Okay, I always find myself doing this just to kind of stretch out that foot. Okay, so both legs straight, hands come down. You can put your fists down if that makes it a little bit easier. Okay, or just your fingers. For me, I'm going to put my hands flat. I've got no excuse to not be able to get them down. Okay, then we're going to lean back into that deeper lunge. Drop the knee. Push forward. Okay, I'm going to actually tell you a little pointer. If you're finding that you're very flexible, you can put your elbows down here on the inside of your leg. I don't really find that one quite comfortable, so I'm gonna keep it up on my palms, okay? Then we lean back. Oh, this is that hamstring that is so tight. Get the nose down. Okay, I'm pushing into the splits. See how even I am very stiff on that left leg. Okay, and then you'll hold that. Okay, is there any movement in Irish dancing that favors one leg over the other? Front clicks, birdies? Well, if you're me and you made up your gypsy, I made everything up on my right leg because that's my strong leg. So anytime I do a birdie, anytime I do a kick or any click or any jump, I'm doing it on my right leg. So I guess that kind of describes or sums up why my left leg is weaker. But that's the beauty of being a professional dancer and making up your own routine. You can do things like that. So you can tailor it to your strengths. I tried the splits. I noticed that it's getting better and better, but I'm still 15 to 20 centimeters away from my goal. That's all right. It's just great that you're getting better and better at each time. And it's really good that you've got a goal. Try to get all the way down. See if you can do, if you can get one centimeter down further, let's say every 2 days. Thanks for keeping the show going. Videos are much better now. Love your accent/dialect. I really enjoy watching your dance class show. Thank you, Chris. You make that look so easy. Eventually it will feel easy to you, and other people will be saying that to you as well. If you just keep doing these stretches, They will. Eventually, you'll just be sliding into the splits. Okay? And remember, do it after a hot shower because you'll find that you'll get like that much lower if your muscles are warm. Okay? Let's do another little bit of a cool down and a stretch together. Just if you've got any last questions, I'm going to leave the music off because it seems that our stream is running smoothly for now. Okay? And I don't want to ruin that. So unfortunately, we won't play the cool down track, but you've got my voice to listen to instead. How does your back cope when you do those bending stretches? Something I get concerned about myself. I'm quite lucky, actually. I've got no back issues, seeing that after I do a lead show and I've done Gypsy, I get kind of a sore pain in my lower back, but that's just from jumping up and down in the split so much. I don't know if you've ever seen my Gypsy, but it seems to be a move that gets my back working a little bit extra, is jumping mid-air into the splits. So I'll be coming up to the end of the routine and I would just go straight into it like that, okay? So that's the bit that would kind of do it for my back, really. You saw Olivia's dog yesterday morning. He was funny. I'll have to see what Winston's doing. See if he can come on and say hi. Your voice is so lovely. Well, thank you. You guys really have given me all the compliments today. Just taking off this shoe for our cool down. I'll see what Winston is doing. And if he's not sleeping, then he can come and say hi to you guys. I know that he went on a long walk today, and like I said, it's so warm, so he gets a little bit tired with the heat. As far as we can tell, Jess replaced her spinal column with a wet spaghetti noodle. I know, Jess is so flexible in the back. I've been quite lucky and fortunate that I've always been very flexible in my legs, but to tell you the truth, my back has never been flexible. It's something that I've really had to work on. Luckily, though, being an Irish dancer, you don't really need a flexible back. You don't see me doing backhand springs all over the stage like Jess does, or aerials or backflips. So, no, I'm lucky. I don't need that flexy back. Okay, let's just do a few stretches first. I don't know if you can hear that my hips are cracking a little bit. Okay, so I'm going to show you one to get those hips opened up and stretch out a little bit more. Few Winston emojis coming in. Your knees are sleeping right now. Are you a cat person as well as a dog person? No, to tell you the truth, I'm just a dog person. I do respect that everybody likes different animals though, and you might not be a dog person, you might only be a cat person, but me personally, I just like dogs. Okay, so sorry, let me explain what I'm doing here. I'm in a glute stretch right now, so I've got my right leg bent in front and my other knee is straight down. Okay, and I'm going to put my elbows down just to stretch out that glute. Okay, and then let's change legs. It's this left side today. Okay, so the exercise I'm going to show you to get your hips opened, it's not far off from the position that we're already in. So you've got one leg bent at the front here, and this other leg is also bent. Looks like next time I need to not wear black leggings. Seems like I'm blending in with my portable sprung floor. But if you can see my socks to show you where my feet are, they're both to the sides, okay? Both knees are bent, my left knee's at the front, and my back knee, I'm just gonna bring it behind me a little bit more, and I'm gonna sit up nice and straight because I'm gonna feel that stretch right here in my right hip. Okay, just hold that stretch there while I answer a few more questions. I can't read that far, unfortunately. My kittens are sleeping right now. Oh, sorry, I already read that one. Appearance on screen is approximately 12 seconds. Got to love tech. Headaches. Winston is probably eating ice cream. Do you know, I actually saw at the pet store they had some type of ice lolly or popsicle, whatever you call it, That's for dogs. So maybe that's something I need to get him for this heat. After the shows, do you go through all these cool down exercises, then the ice beasts? Yes, so you need to stretch, obviously, when you're warm. So the second that encore is done, I would come out into the quick change, get out of my costume, clean up my area, take all my shoes, wrap the laces around them because I'm very neat with the shoes. And I do a ton of stretches before I go into the ice beast. Remember, you can't do it the other way around, because if you did the ice beast, obviously your muscles would get all cold and tight. Yes, I'm not a dog person, but I will say Winston is cute. Oh no. Yeah, see, I guess everybody has different preferences. But Winston is a good boy, and I think he gets a little bit of credit. Just, he was in the original Dance for Hope video. So, I'll see what he's doing, and we'll get a little chat from him. Here he is. Come here. Sorry, bear with me. He's being a little bit naughty. Come here. Here he is. He's not being very cooperative. You are so naughty today. At least he doesn't have his squeaky toy today. Let's give him a little treat. Why are you being so naughty? Okay, that's Winston's stage time over. Now he wants to be my friend. Do you like any particular British accents? Oh, that's a good question. No, I don't think I like any particular ones. They all sound so different though, don't they? Lots of Winston emojis. You light up when Winston comes in. Yes, Winston is my baby. He can do no wrong. I say he's being naughty, but even when he's really bad, he still, in my eyes, he doesn't mean it. It was just an accident. Even if it does mean getting sand all over the house or peeing all over my white couch. Okay, right, everyone. A few more stretches just to finish, okay? Because I know maybe you're not sore, but my legs are dying right now. He's adorable. Yes, and he's nearly 6 months now. He's getting so big. I'm hoping that he's kind of stayed this size now. Okay, so to get these glutes more stretched out, you're going to put one leg up and we're going to sit back into it. Okay, and you should feel this in that left glute. Okay, hold it. You might need to hold onto something if you're finding it hard to balance. But really, you should just be pushing your bum back, okay, so that you can get the glutes fully stretched out. Okay, you might even feel it a little bit on the side here where your IT band is. Just depends where you're sore and how tight you are. Okay. Now, another one that I love doing for my hamstrings, but it's quite painful. Bear with me. Both legs stay straight. Okay, so we can all do this, and we do this quite a bit. I'm going to add a little bit of a twist to it. You're going to bend the right knee, and you're going to keep the left knee straight. Okay, so instead of having both of them straight, bend the right knee, lock your left knee, and then go down. Let me know where you feel that. You should feel it in your opposite leg. So in the straight leg, a little bit deeper. Okay, hold that, get the palms down. Okay, then you're going to change legs, bend the right knee, keep the left knee locked, and go all the way down. Hold it down tight. Okay, a few more questions have just come in. Are there a lot of different American accents? There's also another question. What's your favorite dance with the lads in the show? Okay, so Sarah, you're asking what your favorite dance with the lads in the show is. I love Four Lads. So in the show, when you see both the good girl and the bad girl dancing together, and then the four lads come on, I always chat about how this is one of my favorite numbers. It probably is my favorite number in the show. But that's when you've got two lads on both sides of you, and they pull you right up. They lift you up. That's definitely my favorite dance. And I love seeing how high I can jump each time. Are there a lot of different American accents? Yes, there are, but do you believe it or not, I can't really tell state to state. So if you were from the South, I wouldn't be able to tell which state you were from. I could just tell that you have a Southern accent. Whereas in England, obviously, you can kind of really tell if somebody's from Manchester or if they're from Liverpool. You can really hear the difference. You would think I'd be the opposite way around, but not quite. You can tell if somebody's from the Midwest or if they're from the South in the US. Yes, we forgive our pets within less than 2 seconds. Impossible to be angry at them. That's true, especially when he's a puppy and he just doesn't know if he's right or wrong. How can you be annoyed with him? Is he a Cocker Spaniel? Very close. He's a Springer Spaniel. So they're still classed a medium breed, but he gets a little bit bigger than a Cocker Spaniel. So he's Winston has massive paws. He must have like the same size paw as my hand. So we think he's going to be a big boy. Any questions that you've got, throw them into the chat for me. I've really enjoyed teaching you today and chatting with you. I know we didn't get done as much as we would have liked to because of the jumping, but thank you for bearing with me. And I'm lucky and I'm glad that we did get that breakout done, okay? And the stream didn't affect us too much on that part. Southern New York and just generic American. Oh yes, that's true. I suppose you can tell if somebody's from Boston or if they're from New York. Winston is a 10 out of 10 good boy. What's your favorite American food to eat? Now, another hard food question. Oh, I don't know, Sarah. Everything. Anything. Burgers, hot dogs, macaroni and cheese. Love it all. Can't really say pizza or anything because I guess you could say that's Italian. Thanks, Mary, for everything this evening. Hope you have an enjoyable week. Yes, thank you guys for joining me on another Monday. I hope that it has brightened up your day and that it sets you off to have a really good week. And I hope that you have a fabulous time and you keep practicing and you get better with your steps each week. Don't stop practicing because you're getting better each week. I am confident that you are and you're getting more flexible as well, which is great. You always enjoy them. Good. Glad you enjoy them. What exercises do you particularly like doing? Right now, I particularly like doing loads of squat exercises because there are about 15 different ways that you can squat, and that's an exercise that I've been doing nearly every day and kind of varying them. So we might have to chat about that some more next week. I know Zoltan does a lot of exercises, but maybe we can chat about my favorite ones in particular. Merry Mondays, best start to the week. Thanks, Sarah. Thank you, Mary, for a wonderful stream again. Loved it. Greetings to James. Thanks very much for answering questions. It's been a nice evening. Yes, guys, enjoy the rest of your Monday.